said, I said, here's a lesson you don't get. I said, I said, I said, I said, I loop the loop when I get loose. I said, I said, I said, I said, ignition ignite. Hello and welcome back to the Not Fadeaway podcast. I am your host, Margot D. Thank you so much for coming by and please follow me on all social media at Not Fadeaway Podcast. I know I've been owing you guys some episodes lately, but I had to put the show aside because of some personal issues, but I promise you, in January, there will be new episodes. And some of those subjects will be Jerry Garcia, Kurt Cobain, and the Altamont Festival, just to name a few. So please subscribe to this podcast so you'll never miss an episode. And if you like what you hear, please leave a review. Thank you so much. Now, today's show is really special. It's going to be the last one I do for the year 2017. And I'm going to be speaking to an emerging podcast superstar. His name is John David Booter. And his podcast is called Done Disappeared. And let me tell you guys, everyone is talking about this guy. And they're talking about him because he launched a brand new true crime podcast that is unlike anything you will ever hear in your life. And I think it might be a good idea for you guys, maybe to pause this episode for a sec and go over and check out his show, Done Disappeared with John David Booter. His episodes are about 10 to 15 minutes at a time, and it'll give you an idea of what he's about, what his show's about, and his style. So it might give you a little bit of context before you check out this interview today. I hope you guys enjoy it. I was thrilled to have him on the show, and we had a ball talking about the year 1987. And I hope with this episode that someone out there can help him find Clara Pockets. Clara, wherever you are, we're thinking about you. All right, let's get on to today's show. And everyone, don't get disappeared. Welcome back to the Not Fadeaway podcast. I cannot believe it. I mean, this guy is everywhere. Everyone's talking about his show, Done Disappeared. On the line today, I have John David Booter. Hello.
Hello, Megan. It's a pleasure to be here.
It's so nice to have you here. So can you please introduce yourself a little bit and tell our audience what your show is about? Because we're not a true crime podcast. I'm a music podcast, but I really want my audience to hear about this case because I think they can help you.
I think, yeah, there's a great crossover between true crime and music. You know, there's a flow to both. There's a sense of fun, a sense of danger, and a sense, there's a melodic sense to both true crime and you know, music itself. So just a little bit about me. My name is John David Booter. I'm a filmmaker, a documentary filmmaker, a prolific filmmaker. And I was brainstorming ideas to make my first documentary film. And I realized it would take a lot of work. It would take a lot of hard work. It would take a whole crew. So I realized that if I streamlined that idea into a podcast, I could do it all myself, and it would really be, you know, it wouldn't take as much time. So I came across the case on Google of a woman from Davistown, Pennsylvania, my hometown, who disappeared in 1987. She went to the local Piggly Wiggly to buy a cake for her youngest daughter's birthday party and was never seen again. All that was found was the cake smeared on the pavement outside the Piggly Wiggly with a tire track going through it. And that's about all we know. It happened on October 1987. And we're trying to get to the bottom of it. We're searching for answers. And it's people like you and your podcast, Never Go Away, that will help us get the word out there and, you know, keep our eyes peeled for this beautiful young Pennsylvania mother.
So you, according to your show, because your episodes are about 10 to 15 minutes apiece, so they're real easy to get through. There are no photographs available of Clara.
We have not been able to locate a single photograph. Fortunately, we have many eyewitness accounts that have provided very detailed descriptions of her, which seem to all line up. So we have a good sense of what she looks like. We have a sketch artist working right now to create a composite drawing so we can start posting it, plastering it around just about everywhere we can have it not be ripped down. You know, people like to tear down flyers, but you know, we're just about there. It's coming together. She's using some matte pencils along with some watercolor, and I think it's really coming together.
So you live with your mother, June, correct?
I do, yes, my mother June.
How is she handling your success? Yeah, in the basement. So how is she handling your success? Is this surprising to her?
You know, she hasn't mentioned it. We barely speak. We've almost never spoken throughout my childhood. We barely said, you know, three words to each other, but she seems to, you know, just be living the life she's always lived, and you can't blame her for that. But, you know, I'm hoping one day, if we do find Clara, and if this podcast becomes the success that I believe that it can, she will, in fact, acknowledge my accomplishments and maybe even look me in the eye and tell me she loves me.
Well, I hope for that and nothing less than that. And I wanted to ask you, because of the music angle, that's the way our podcast goes. You tell us about Johann Johannesburg.
Yes, Johann Johannesburg is our composer. He created our theme song and a host of haunting melodies that we use throughout the show. He's an 11-year-old prodigy that my mother June found singing at her church. He came over to the house to rake some leaves and just started plunking away at my father's organ. My father blew up in the war but left a giant organ, which is about all I have of him. And Johann Johannesburg just came into the home, started plunking away, and my God, if I wasn't moved. So I started taking him out of school for weeks at a time to create these beautiful, beautiful melodies and just giving him pages and pages of notes every pass, and he takes criticism like a little champ, and I think he has a bright future ahead of him, and I think Done Disappeared is the launching pad that will get him greater gigs and a lot of recognition. So I'm just blown away by him. I think he's a great kid, you know.
Yeah, he is. He's very talented. So you've been having some issues because one of the ways you're trying to find her is with her cell phone records. Have you had any progress with that?
You know, it's very strange. We went to the Davistown Police Department and asked for the cell phone records from October 1987, and they claimed that they did not exist. So we're worried that there might be some corruption in the police department. There might be a cover-up here. They might have destroyed these cell phone records, and they might know more than they're telling us.
Is there anybody actively working on the case there?
It doesn't seem like it. In fact, when we mentioned Clara Pockets, we were met with sort of a dumbstruck expression from the officers at the station. You know, they kind of looked glazed over. And it took them about five full minutes to even respond. So
Gotcha. It
seems as though the case is still frigid, very cold.
So for people outside of the U.S., can you explain what a Piggly Wiggly is?
A Piggly Wiggly is a grocery store, you know, where you'd buy your meats, your cheeses, your produce, or household items, detergent, soaps, anything really. It's just your typical supermarket with a giant pig as a mascot.
So have you had any new leads lately? Anything new come in?
You know, we have episode 6 coming out next Wednesday, and we have some rock solid leads that hopefully will lead us to some answers that the Davistown police themselves were never able to find. So we're very excited about that. Be sure to tune in. And, you know, this isn't about me, it's about Clara, and we're also selling some beautiful non-binary blouses that I designed myself to raise awareness and raise funds for the podcast Done Disappeared with me, John David Booter, and me, John David Booter, you know, just to sort of live my life and be able to support myself, maybe move out of the basement from my mother June's house.
Yeah, dare to dream it, it'll happen. So
thank you so much.
And thank you once again for being on the show. So just like off the top of the head, can you give everybody your social media shout outs just in case something jogs in their mind about Clara?
Absolutely. On Twitter, I am at Done Disappeared. On Instagram, I am at Done Disappeared. On Facebook, I am at Done Disappeared. On Snapchat, I am at Done Disappeared. On Bumble, I am Done Disappeared. On Tinder, I am Done Disappeared. And on Raya, I am Jason Alexander. You have to be famous to get on that one. So I just made an account for Jason Alexander from Seinfeld.
That's very clever. So we're going to be talking about 1987 today. So let me just give you a few facts about 1987, just to give it some context.
So let's hear it.
So the median income per person was $24,350. The average monthly rent was $350.
Can you imagine? My mother June charges me
$1,200. Is it rent stabilized?
It's supposed to be rent control, but she pretty much just does whatever she wants. She slips a note under the basement door whenever she decides to raise it. I think she's trying to price me out, honestly.
So a gallon of gas was 89 cents.
Mm, delicious.
Right? This was the year that The Simpsons first appeared on Fox TV.
Oh.
Yep.
Earlier than I thought.
Yep. Aretha Franklin this year was the first woman inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
God bless her.
Right. Prozac made its debut in 1987.
And it's still going strong, let me tell you.
God bless Prozac. This is also the year that televangelist Jim Baker had his big scandal with Jessica Hahn. That was a big deal. All these holy rollers were kind of meeting their media makers at this time. It was pretty incredible. And then the popular movies. There were many, many popular movies in 1987. There was great movies that came out that year. But we have Three Men and a Baby.
Oh.
Yep. Fatal Attraction. A classic. Fatal Attraction.
I know what that's like.
Yep. And Lethal Weapon.
That's interesting. Because that's exactly what we're looking for in this case. Could be the linchpin.
Exactly. And in 1987, Hillary Duff was born.
Oh, God. What a terrible year.
Okay, so are we ready to go through? These are the top 10 songs of 1987. And I was alive then. I was a teenager working at the mall, and I know all of these songs. So they're just coming back in my brain here. But we're going to go 10 to 1. And the first song is Living on a Prayer. So what do you think?
Well, I'm living on a prayer that we can find Clara Pockets. So there's something about this song that really rings true to me. Every day I get out of my sleep number bed and I kneel next to it and I pray. I pray to the Lord to help me, John David Booter, find this 1987 missing woman, you know, and without his help, I don't know if I'll be able to do it, because at this point, he seems like the only one who could tell us anything about what happened to Clara Pockets. So, Bon Jovi, thank you. Thank you for writing this hit song. Thank you for, doing you. Thank you for inspiring me to continue my quest to find Clara Pockets.
And so number 9, this is from the Beverly Hills Cop 2 soundtrack. It's called Shakedown by Bob Seger.
Again, very appropriate. I think a shakedown is exactly what needs to happen at the Pennsylvania Police Department. I think they need to have a real shakedown, look for the evidence that they lost, including the cell phone records, including all of the social media from 1987, and they need to hand it over. They need to give it to me, because if they're not going to investigate it, then they need to let the public have all the information so we can take it into our own hands.
So next up, it's Bruce Hornsby and The Range. And it's The Way It Is. Can't buy a job. And I just wonder if the cops just think that when they talk to you, you know what, John David Booter, it's just the way it is. She's just not here.
You know, I think that's been the general attitude about the case. It's she's gone. She's done disappeared. And that's just the way it is. And that's not how I think. I think I think it does not have to be that way. It could be a different way. She could be home. She could be with her family. We could find her family. And this all could be behind us if we all just work together and crack this case. This does not have to be the way it is.
Next up, we have Whitesnake. The big hair rock was really popular at the time, and this was a huge hit for them. They had Tawny Catane on the cars doing flips, and it's "Here I Go Again."
You know, I think of this tune every time I sit down to record a new episode. Sort of, I'll check the social media responses. I'll look at my reviews on iTunes. Sometimes I get one star. Sometimes people accuse me of being some sort of joker, some sort of court jester, and it hurts. It bums me out. So sometimes I'll sit down on my computer to make a new episode, and I know I've promised myself that I will complete this, and I will see it to its fruition, and I just say, you know what, here I go again, on my own, and I'm going to do it. Whether or not people are behind me, I'm going to do it, and here I go again.
And next up, we have the first of many, many, many hits for the artist known as Robbie Neville. This song was called C'est la vie.
C'est la vie, you know. Another thing the police, I think, said to themselves all the time. Just, this woman done disappeared. We can't find her. C'est la vie. And I don't think that's the right attitude for this or any investigation.
Next up, we have, now, this is a band. They were known as Jefferson Airplane in the 60s. Then they were Jefferson Starship in the 70s. And then in the 80s, they had a couple of crazy pop hits. And this comes from the soundtrack for the movie Mannequin. And it's called... Nothing's gonna stop us now. Oh,
You know, I tell myself this every day, you know, when I'm met with either a dead end lead or someone disparaging my podcast, Don't Disappear With Me, John David Booter, I just say nothing's going to stop us now. And Mannequin is a movie that I treasure. I watch it weekly, if not daily. I find it to be a riveting expose of the human condition. And, you know, it's a movie that's close to my heart. And I think if you watch it, you'll understand a lot more about me. And you'll understand a lot more about my sensibilities. So I would love, as a filmmaker, a movie like Mannequin is a dream of mine. I would love to make a film as powerful and as timely and as timeless as that film.
I think it's James Spader's best performance by far.
Absolutely. Absolutely. What a brilliant thespian, you know?
Yep. Okay, so number four for the year, 1987, is somebody who will probably be the subject of a future Not Fade Away episode, Ms. Whitney Houston, R.I.P.
Mm.
I love this song. It's called I Wanna Dance With Somebody, and then in parentheses, Who Loves Me?
You know, I've been listening to this song a lot since my harrowing breakup with my fiancée, Lisa, who left me for a tennis coach named Robert Barkley. You know, after being in a relationship for years and years where you have a constant support system, just someone behind your back, and just to have that all taken away, it's jarring, it's shocking. And having gained 215 pounds, you know, I now weigh 387 pounds, it's difficult for me to walk, to stand, let alone dance. And really all I want to do is dance with somebody who loves me. It's true. It rings very true. And I think hopefully if this case is solved, if we do make a name for ourselves, I will be able to afford a trainer to sort of shed the weight, get up on my feet, start cutting a rug like I used to back in my Casanova days. And maybe someone will learn to love me and come down to the basement and dance with me.
Well, John David Booter, when you bring them down to your basement, you're going to want to have a slow jam going, right?
Absolutely.
To get to second base. So this was a huge slow jam song in 1987. Here it is. It's Shake You Down from Gregory Abbott.
Times before now, baby, I see that look in your
God, what a beautiful, beautiful song. And again, I think this is a song that I would love to play for people that I interview that may be hiding something, just to sort of disarm them, get them in a loose sort of giving mood, and then really shake them down, really shake that information out of them. You know, catch them off guard with the sweet, soulful sound of Gregory Abbott, and then just shake them down and get those facts, you know, because that's my mission and I won't stop until it's done.
So number two, it's one of those songs, it was very popular at the time. Heart is the band. Heart was a hard rock band in the 70s. Then in the 80s, they let the hair go crazy and they were doing all these power ballads and everybody loved this song. And if you listen to The Voice or America's Got Talent or any of those shows where they have a woman belting a song, at one point they make her sing this. And the song is Alone.
You know, it's funny that this song came up, Meredith, because since podcasts like yours started having me on their show to sort of spread the word, you know, I was doing this all alone. I mean, till now, I've always got by on my own. I never really cared until I met you. And I'm constantly asking myself, like, how do I get my listeners alone? How do I get them alone? I need to get them alone. So they can really focus on the facts, on the information I'm giving. If they're surrounded by a bunch of people, yap, 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 and, you know, they're going to miss something. So it's important for me to release these episodes at times of the day, on days when people are completely isolated. So this song, it again, rings very true. It's very apropos, and I'm sure to listen to it again.
That was beautiful. And, you know, when you're alone with them, you're going to want to use those Brooklinen sheets to kind of wrap yourselves up, right?
So comfortable you could take a giant shit in them.
Oh, there's nothing better than that, I'm telling you. That's true love. So we have one more to go. You ready for the number one song from 1987?
Absolutely.
It's the Bangles, and I remember this. You couldn't escape this goddamn song. It was literally everywhere, and it's one of those songs your parents really liked. This is Walk Like an Egyptian.
God, you know, that sends my mind racing. You know, if Clara heard that song before her disappearance and somehow got it in her head that she needed to move to Egypt, just escape her life and jet set over to Egypt and live the life of some sort of Egyptian, you know, someone who walked like that, I feel like that could have resulted in her fleeing, leaving her life behind, you know, and that was the number one song. I think a lot of people probably had that idea. And certainly Clara could have been one of them.
You know, I didn't think of that, but you're absolutely right. That absolutely could have been there. We have to think about that. Maybe you have to go to Egypt next.
Absolutely. And Egypt is a place where almost no one has ever been. So if she had gone there, it would be almost impossible to trace her.
If anybody could do it, I bet you could do it.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that.
Well, I want to thank you for being on the show today. It was so much fun talking about this stuff. So once again, tell everybody how they can find you.
Absolutely. My name is John David Booter. I'm a filmmaker. I've never made a podcast. You can find my podcast on iTunes and Buzzsprout. It's called Done Disappeared with me, John David Booter. And I'm also on Facebook, Tinder, Bumble, Raya, Instagram, Snapchat, and LinkedIn. So please reach out. Let us know if you've seen anything, and keep in touch. Just let me know how you're doing. Let me know what's up, and maybe a friendship could be born out of this. Who knows?
And I want to thank everybody for listening to the show. This is the last show of the year. I will be back with new episodes January 2018. We're going to be talking about Jerry Garcia, Kurt Cobain, and the Altamont Festival. So looking forward to that. So John David Booter, thank you so much again.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for listening to the Not Fade Away podcast. And if you like what you hear, please subscribe wherever you get your podcasts. And if you love what you hear, yay, please leave a review. It helps us so much more than you could ever know. You can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Not Fade Away Podcast. You can email us with comments or suggestions to notfadeawaypodcast@gmail.com. And if you want to learn more about my other shows, Book Versus Movie, The Fit Bottom Girls, and The Best Neighbors Podcast, just follow me at Brooklyn Fit Chick on all social media, or check out my main blog, brooklynfitchick.com. Thanks so much. Go out there and kick ass today.